there's some lesson. I'm going to 1 through 10. Give your work meaning.
Yes.
Trust your people. If you give people freedom, they will amaze you. Yes. Hire only people who are better than you.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well,
those are the people you'll learn from. Those are the people who will.
Well, honestly, yes. I mean, you'll learn, they'll do great work, but it's kind of selfish as well, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, if you're hiring people better than you, your job actually gets easier,
right?
And so you want to look for that. And if you want an institution, you know, one of the things Larry and Sergey observed early on was that, you know, startups start and they start with a core of amazing people. And then the next set of people they hire out, the next concentric ring out, you know, are pretty darn good. And then the third ring, not so much, because each concentric ring doesn't know what to look for.
So when you've gone from 60 to 60,000, you've gotten progressively better or worse?
Typically, the typical experience is worse, and that's part of why company performance reverts to mean over time.
Yeah.
So their idea was, keep hiring people better than you, and your company will actually get stronger over time rather than end up average.
Number 4 is don't confuse development with managing performance.
That's right.
Number 5, focus on the two tails. Mm-hmm. The biggest opportunities lie in your absolute worst and best employees.
Mm-hmm.
Absolute worst.
Absolute worst. So part of the premise there is that you're doing hiring in a thoughtful, unbiased, objective way, which means you don't have to fire a lot of people, right, as you point out earlier.
Yeah.
In our case, what happens is we actually periodically go through and identify our bottom 5%, but it doesn't affect their ratings, it doesn't affect their bonus or anything, because you might have a team where everyone's doing a good job.
Right.
There's still a bottom person on that team. We tell them, and we try to get them better. And what we find is about a third of the time they get better, two-thirds of the time they don't, and we have them switch jobs. And 80% of the time there, so about 50% overall, they get a lot better. We've put them in the wrong job.
Right.
Right? It's not that they're bad people.
I think that's important to, you know, have people doing something that turns them on and therefore their performance is better.
Yes.
You know, something that they have some natural gift to do.
And this, by the way, this is something that's tough for a manager, right? Because you build your team and you want to work with them. You like them, the good people, you want to keep them. You need to be able to encourage people to move around because they'll keep growing and in the long term.
Yeah, but at the same time, you don't want the person who shows up on day one and on day two, they're looking at their next job.
That's correct.
You know,
that's
and therefore they don't pay attention on the job you hired them to do. I always say to people, you know, really do well what we have hired you to do, and you become indispensable for us, and therefore we want to do something for you. Be frugal and generous.
Mm-hmm.
Pay unfairly.
That's
an interesting thing.
Yeah. Well, so HR departments typically make the assumption that human performance follows a normal distribution. You know, you got your top 10, your bottom 10, you got your vast unwashed middle. If you look at sports, though, it follows what's called a power law distribution, right? There's a few people who are so exceptionally good, so much better than everybody else. Pick your Kobe Bryants, your Michael Jordans, your LeBron James, that they pull the whole curve up.
Right.
And if you plot sort of average performance across some of these industries, what you'll find is that most people in basketball actually perform below average because these exceptional people are so much better. And nobody looks at it and says, well, it's crazy they make so much money.
You know, it's an interesting argument, and I don't know what the results are, nor do I have necessarily have an opinion. Some people will say you need a couple of superstars, but you don't need 5 superstars because if you have too many superstars, they will begin to step all over each other.
Well, but that gets, again, to hiring and the kind of profile you're looking for, right? If you have people who can work together, right, who are intellectually humble, right, it doesn't matter if they've got huge egos. If they can admit new information and say, you know what, actually, I'm amazing, but I was wrong on these 3 things, and thank you, and now I'm going to do it differently, you get as many superstars as you can.
Pay unfairly.
Yeah.
Nudge a lot. Small signals can cause large changes in behavior.
Yeah.
You know what else I think? I mean, and you wrote the book, and you're the expert. It is that we think we're praising, but we're not praising enough. Mm-hmm. We're justified.
Yeah, the academic research on this shows that that people feel negative feedback with 10 times the intensity of positive feedback. And most positive feedback is also not particularly specific, right? Like negative feedback is like, you screwed up this presentation, you're a bonehead. Positive feedback is, great job, attaboy. So you not only need to, if you want to have a positive impact on somebody, be more frequent with it, but you need to be very specific so that somebody knows, here's the specific thing, you know, when you were sitting at this table, you leaned a certain way and that came across well, or you didn't, but that specificity makes the feedback that much more meaningful.
And then finally, manage the rising expectations. That's finally, this is 9. Manage the rising expectations.
Yeah, anytime, you know, my thesis is that basically there's 2 ways to run a business and make a lot of money. One is you can treat people pretty badly. And there's enough people who need work that they're gonna take the job, and you can grind through them. The other is to do what we've tried to do in places like Wegmans have tried to do. Treat people well, you get more for it. But what ends up happening then is as soon as you say, we're going to do all these great things for you, people habituate very quickly, right? And they say, you know, I mean, it's like, you know, imagine getting a salary increase. The first time you get one, it's amazing, and 3 months later you've spent it, and it doesn't feel so good anymore. So you need to let people know, we're trying this, we're embarking on a journey, and we'll see how it goes.
Number 10 is enjoy, and then go back to number 1 and start all over again.
Yeah, it takes practice to get this stuff right.